As a members of the committee members, our suggestion is that ki we will generate e-content for all the students of the University of Mumbai. So for that, we want your active participation in creating the e-content for various module. And in that, I think lab manual is also an important part. For the theory like CPPF, the e-content can be in the form of a document where we write very targeted about each and every module and examples related to that module. All of you will be teaching through the virtual environment, so every one of you will be creating some sort of notes, some sort of PowerPoint presentations, and putting the material in an e-form. So we also want all of you to contribute in this, and let us divide this work among all of us who are teaching this subject for the first time, and develop e-content for the University of Mumbai, for all the students of University of Mumbai. And on the same line, we can develop the lab manual also in a part by part manner. We are not saying that we are going to develop it within one night or one day or within one week's time, but we can have a time span of a month, and we can generate the e-content for the every module, which will be distributed to all the staff faculty members. It will be beneficial for the students, it will be beneficial for the other faculty members who in future may take up this subject for the teaching. So that is the idea behind the e-content generation. So we want active participation, and we want nominations from you who can help us in generating the e-content. The flow, how it has to be done, and everything will be guided by me and Anup Kunte sir. But we want a voluntary participation from all of you. So Anup sir will be floating a Google form after some time, sure, in your WhatsApp group, where you can let us know you are comfortable with which particular module e-content generation. Then maybe we can form a group of teachers module wise, and then we can decide the timeline, and we can generate the e-content for the same. And same way, we will ask for the lab also, so that we can generate the lab manual according to the lab, according to the module wise, and then compile and make a what you can say e-book kind of thing, ready reckoner or ready reference, which can be distributed to the students as well as the faculty members of every organization. Fine, thank you. I hope I'm.
Thank you, ma'am. Yeah, thank you, ma'am.
Something more to add, sir?
Yeah, I'll add a few things. You have covered almost everything. I will be also sharing a Docker image for which comprises of all the software that are required for conducting the lab, which may be helpful to you to have a virtual lab setup in your premises. How to do that? Probably we can talk about that in tomorrow's session. I want to announce that tomorrow from 2 to 5, there will be two sessions. One session based on Prolog, and another session based on functional programming. And there will be another session day after tomorrow, which will be taken up for guiding you for the module 2 of the practical syllabus, that is functional programming. And there we are going to discuss details about the experiments that are going to be there in the lab. So we'll be actually doing a hands-on session over there, wherein you can actually know what problem code is there, how to execute it, etc. Since this is the Haskell is first time introduced, we are making sure that we at least give a brief idea. I know many of you must have already learned it and started preparing for it, because many of the colleges have already resumed their working. But still, from our side as a syllabus team, we are going to take efforts in organizing a 2 days short workshop. It's a very short workshop. We are not going into much details, but over the period of 2 days, we are going to actually take efforts for giving you a brief idea about how to conduct the lab. And that is the purpose of the workshop. Now, I guess the session is open for the questions. So if you have any questions, you can actually raise those questions through the chat window, or maybe
or you can unmute yourself and can ask.
You can ask also, or you can post. Yeah.
Few questions we have answered already in the chat section. Still, if you have any questions, please ask.
I have a question.
Yeah,
can I ask?
Yeah. Go ahead, ma'am.
My name is Anita Senati from RAIT. The syllabus is suggesting third edition of Scott ML, whereas the fourth edition is the latest. So can we refer the fourth edition book?
You can always refer the fourth edition book, but make sure that there are no major changes in the book, because the syllabus has been mapped to third edition, and that is why we are restricting the discussion about the third edition only. So the concepts in from the fourth editions also you could take, but they should not be totally different. So that's the thing. So because many of the programming languages, newer programming languages, are not been taught to the students, and third edition surely does not cover any particular programming language as such. That is why the third edition is used. Okay.
Okay.
I hope it answers the question.
Hello.
Yeah, sir.
Hello. Good evening, all. This is Professor Prashant Samant from PGCIIT Science. Sir, actually, my question is regarding the prerequisite point, that prerequisite model. In syllabus, we have mentioned about the compiler part. So, in exam section, should we cover some small part of that? Because last times it has happened that in university question, some part asked from the prerequisite part. So, is it necessary to include some part of the prerequisite model in term test 1 or term test 2 or university exam? Hello.
Yes, sir.
Yeah, go ahead.
I think there is not much in prerequisite. It is just making students understand about the how compiler works and how interpreter works, and that way.
Yeah, right.
So there won't be any major such kind of question from the prerequisite. So if you wish, you can include, but actually in when we are setting a question paper, there is no question from the prerequisite.
At least in the NSEM, there won't be any question on the prerequisite, but the internal question, a faculty member can decide to have one just to evaluate the students' abilities, whether they have actually studied those things or not. For the sake of evaluation, you can have that in any internal examination, maybe.
Okay.
If it relates.
And one more question. Thank you so much. One more question. In second model, there is a lot of differences there. So to what depth we have to teach this model? Lambda calculus is, let's say, it's vast topic, so we have to go to the application layer or just introductory part of lambda calculus?
It is just the introductory part of the lambda calculus, but because these are the students at third semester level, they might not have that much background in discrete mathematics as well. And programming as well, they have just had a course just now, and again, even if it would have been conducted completely, still just knowing C and very little of mathematics background, we are not going to focus on the lambda calculus. It's just a very shallow introduction to lambda calculus, because students should not feel ke kahan se aata hai functional programming, we don't know anything about it.
Yes.
That is the reason it is included. Although that is a very crisp and nice topic, we are not going into the details of it, and that is why the weightage of 1 hour should be there, and that is what even the Gomes ma'am told. In her slide, she had 2 hours, but in the discussion, she said it all depends on the faculty members and the students, interest of the students. Okay, but as far as the theory syllabus is concerned, it's just an introduction to lambda calculus.
Okay, thank you so much.
Yeah. Any other questions? Anjita ma'am, any particular thing from the
no, sir.
That we have not answered? Chat box?
One question,
sir. All the questions from chat box. There is,
sir, someone is asking some myself.
Bharti ma'am, go ahead.
Okay. Sir, actually our college started with the subject, so anyhow I have to take before this. I got every material from net and from ebooks.
Yeah.
Okay. Now it is proper. Sir, actually our college started with this subject. Okay. And what problems I am facing is, like, when I am giving examples, like I can say the topic, this type system, type checking, storage management, these parts, when I'm giving example, but student don't know any of the language except C programming. Okay, so they don't know anything about this object, class kya hai, public, private, these things, they don't know anything. So when I'm giving example, first I have to explain everything about that language. Okay, all these things are happening in the object oriented. So should we do that way or something else you can suggest? Because I'm facing a lot for this.
Yeah, that's a challenge, I guess, that everybody amongst us is going to face. And we have to devise. Yeah, go ahead, ma'am. Deepali, ma'am.
Can very well make them introduce to C++ because there is not much difference between C and C++. You can take help of little bit of C++ and make them little bit comfortable while learning. But do not go in much details which will confuse them entirely in their learning part of it. That is our suggestion. Yes, definitely we are going to face a problem because we have not specified any language, and teaching those constructs without any concrete language knowledge will be a little bit difficult. So you can take small like codes and explain them a little bit of background, and then you can go ahead with your modules.
Okay, thank you, ma'am.
Any other questions?
More questions in chat section also.
Only one participant has asked that can we use online coding platform
online
to program?
Like online GDB.
Yeah. So Deepali ma'am has already answered it. Yes, you can use any coding platform. Whatever comfortable you can use. No more questions, I think.
I think there are no more questions.
Yeah.
Related to e-content, we will post the Google form kindly. We expect cooperation from all of you to generate the e-content because it will be really helpful for every one of us as well as yes. To the students. We all are here to work for the betterment of the students. So I hope everyone will voluntarily participate in creation of e-content.
So yes, we'll be posting this particular form maybe by today evening, late evening, and we expect you to give your suggestions as well, which platform we could actually have such thing done, like. Okay.
Yeah. So your suggestions and ideas are most welcome.
Participants are requesting to share the PPT. He will be sharing this PPT with you all. So there is one more question in the chat section by Prashant Savan, sir. Virtual programming laboratory is good for lab session to access students' performance during e-lab. It's open source. Okay, just a suggestion. Thank you, Prashant, sir.
Nice suggestion.
Thank you. Nice suggestion, sir. Thank you so much. Sir, can we... post the attendance and feedback link in chat section, Anup sir. Anup sir, are you there?
Yeah, I'm there. I'll be posting it into the chat section as well as on the WhatsApp group. I've mailed it to the participants as well. So yeah. They might have got the mail.
Yes, they got it.
They have received it, yes.
Yeah, so if somebody has missed the mail, I'm sending it in the WhatsApp group as well. So if there are no more questions, is Vaishali ma'am there?
Yes, sir.
Hello.
Yes, sir.
Is Vaishali ma'am there?
Yeah.
You would want to add something?
Yeah. No, it's covered. Almost it is covered everything.
So from yeah, fine. So I would like to place a vote of thanks. Actually, this is going to continue tomorrow also and day after tomorrow also. So just a vote of thanks for this particular faculty orientation program. So those who attended the faculty